Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and welcome back to Gal. Today, I'm showing you another TikTok effect. This one is also by Flores Creates, where he creates really cool dancing TikToks. And in this particular effect, just the color of his shirt is changing as he dances. So how did he achieve this effect? Well, you can use Premiere Pro's Lumetri Curves to be able to isolate a color and change the color of that existing color. But if your subject is wearing a shirt that has a similar color as the background, the color will also change in the background. So this is why it's important to pre-plan. So when I spoke with Flores Creates, we had a little chat on Clubhouse. He talked about how he created this effect, and essentially he had to do a lot of rotoscoping because he had this problem where his shirt was a similar color to the background. So he ended up having to do some rotoscoping inside of After Effects. And so this is a lesson learned for you guys. If you want to create this effect and you haven't yet filmed, be sure to wear a shirt that's a very different color from the background. Or another thing to keep in mind is not wear a shirt that's similar to skin tones, because it will also affect the skin tone. So if you are wearing a red shirt, there's also red in your skin. If you're wearing a brown shirt, there's some browns, there's some beiges. Just be careful about that as well. Now, you can't really control this. I mean, sometimes you're filming and you forget to think about it. So it's something that might be out of your control if it's already filmed. So that's why I chose a clip that's very similar to Flores' Creates video, where the person in the video is wearing a similar colored shirt as the background. So the same sort of issue happened. So this is why I'm going to show you how to rotoscope and also do the color correction. And this clip was provided by Mixkit. Thank you so much to Mixkit for supporting today's video tutorial. And Mixkit, you can access hundreds of free stock video, music, sound effects, and templates. And I made a full tutorial detailing how to use their transitions already in Premiere Pro that you can click up here to check out if you're interested in those free transitions. But without further ado, enough with this intro, and let's go ahead and jump on in to Premiere Pro. So for this particular demo clip, you will see that as we try to change the color of his blue shirt, it will also change the background color as well. So let me show you how this works. So let's first zoom into his shirt from the program panel to about 150%. And then we can use the side scroll bar so that way we have a nice view of the shirt color. Now go to Lumetri Color panel. And if you do not see the Lumetri Color panel, you can go to Window and Lumetri Color to open it up. And from Lumetri, go to Curves. So here, go to Hue versus Hue. And all that Hue versus Hue does is enable you to change the color of an existing color. So Hue is just another fancy word for color. So select the Hue versus Hue dropper tool and go to select the blue color of the shirt. And now we are given points to manipulate. If we move the center point up to a different hue, you can see it's changing the color of the background and the shirt. Same if we move it down to another color in the spectrum. And if we expand the hue range by moving the outer points out to encompass more of the blue color and create more points and bring it up, it only affects the background more. So this is why we need to rotoscope and remove the subject's shirt from the rest of the scene and then do the color correction. So let's remove the Lumetri color effect from the effect controls just by pressing delete on this effect. And next, let's first duplicate the layer in our timeline. To do that, you're going to hold the Alt key on your PC or the Option key on a Mac and drag it up. And next, we can just turn off this bottom layer as we don't need it, so just turn off that visibility. Now from the top layer, we need to isolate the part we want to rotoscope by pressing C to get the razor tool. So I'm going to scrub to the first part I want to cut and then click to cut at this moment. And then I'll scrub to the point where I want the color change effect to end, and I will also click to cut there. Now the reason why I'm just cutting out this portion of the clip is that when you're rotoscoping, you want to have the least amount of frames as possible so that way it's faster. Only the necessary part, only the part that we actually want to change the color, which isn't on the whole clip. So once you have that done, to rotoscope, we need to use After Effects. So right click on this clip and select Replace with After Effects Composition. And this will open up After Effects. Now in After Effects, we have the clip. Let's double click on this layer in our composition to open it up in the layer panel. Now we can use the RotoBrush tool to paint green over the subject to select the shirt only. Now the reason we are not selecting his entire body is because there's also blue tones in his shoes and other parts of his body. It's okay if you have a little bit of his arm because there's no blue colors in his arm, but we want to avoid the hair as well because the hair has a little bit of areas where you can see the background peeking through and we don't want that color in between his hairs changing as well. So just be careful to select just the shirt. And as you're rotoscoping and selecting, you can always deselect unwanted parts by pressing the Alt key on a PC or Option on a Mac and then clicking to remove those areas, and you will see that it's red when you're removing it. So then once it's done, you can press the space bar and the RotoBrush tool will start to predict the edges. And as it starts to predict, you might have to stop and go in and fix any part of the selection. You can also go to the paintbrush panel to adjust the size of the RotoBrush if needed to make it easier to fix finer parts of the roto. So once the rotoscope is done, you can scrub through and see it perfectly cuts out the shirt throughout. And to make it even better, you can go to the RotoBrush effect controls and turn on the motion blur for the roto to make it more realistic. And then we can shift the edge a bit outward to make sure we got all of the shirt, so none of the edges are missing. So we can try 50% and you can see it slightly shifts outward. And if you click, you can also increase it to 100%, but this might be a little bit too much. So I'm going to bring it down to around 25%, and you can see how that looks. And I'm going to actually change it to 15%. So now when we go back to the comp, you can see it's perfectly cut out with a transparency layer. Essentially, it's just a moving mask. And it's okay that if you have some of the arm rotoed in here because there are no blue tones in the arm skin. So we're safe for that. But if you do have a red shirt, then you probably don't want the arm to be in it because there are some red tones in the arm and you don't want that to affect the skin when we're inside of Premiere. So now go back to Premiere and we can see the comp is now here in our timeline and you can also see it's transparent. If you don't see the transparency grid and just black behind it, it's still transparent. But if you want the transparency grid on, you can just go to the wrench tool and click and scroll down to enable the transparency grid. So that's how you get the transparency grid on. So once we've isolated the shirt, we can turn back on this background layer by just clicking on the little eyeball there. And now we can select the dynamically linked comp here in our timeline. And now let's zoom in again to see the color better to around 100%. And you can use these sliders in the program monitor to better see the shirt. And now we can go back to Lumetri Color panel and open up the curves and go down to Hue Saturation Curves. And from Hue versus Hue, use the dropper tool to select the blue color of the shirt. This will make 3 points, just like I showed you earlier in the video, of the blue color. And you can move this middle one up to adjust the hue, let's say to a green color. And you can always widen the hue selection to include more blue by moving the left point over to more of the lighter blue. And then you can click on this line and make a new point and pull this point up as well so it's in the same hue. And then you can scrub through to make sure all of the blues are being included in your timeline and do the same with the far right blues. We're going to move all of these dots up in the same line so that way it's the same color of green. And the reason why I created these extra points here is that way we can make sure that all of the blue in the shirt is going to be chained to this new green color. So you need to be careful and scrub through the timeline to make sure that you're including all of the blues that are in the shirt. And then you can just make adjustments to these points that fits your scene. So now we can adjust the hue versus luma, which will adjust the brightness of this color. The luma is just the brightness. So use the dropper tool here to select the shirt color. And you'll notice that when we select the green color, it still picks the blue hue. And that's because Lumetri is still referencing the original blue color and that's okay. So what we can do is move up this middle point to increase the brightness of the shirt, and you can see if you do it too much, it won't look that natural. So just a subtle amount, and again, you can widen the hue range by moving the points, clicking on the line to add another point, and you can do the same to the other side, and it will just brighten it up all at the same level when you move these to the same exact line. Once you get it to where you like it, you can uncheck the effect to see the before and after. I think it looks a little too bright, so I'm just going to bring this down just a little bit more. And another thing you can change is the saturation of the color by using the hue versus saturation. So let's see how this works. Same as before, you can adjust the middle point to bring up the saturation for more of a saturated look, or bring it down to desaturate it. I'll add another point and bring it up so we can add a slight bit more saturation for this effect. So now we can go back to fit the video to the program monitor and we see the full video in frame. And because we isolated just the shirt, we can see the color change is only affecting the shirt itself and not the rest of the image. And as we scrub through, you can see it goes from blue to green. And if we want to change the color again, just press C on your keyboard to create the razor tool and make a cut at the point where you want the color to change. And you can do this as many times as you want. Then you can scrub ahead again to the next point you want it to change and make a cut point there. And since the Lumetri color effect is already applied, all we need to do now is go to the hue versus hue parameter and change these points to our desired color. In our case, let's go ahead and move these up to the orange color. So you might see as you do this that it doesn't change immediately, and that's because there's some type of bug happening here, and I hope the Premiere Pro team is watching this. But what I had to do is click off and then kind of move the playhead, and then you can see the orange color there. So once you see the orange color, you can make some more adjustments if you like, such as the hue versus saturation, and you can make these points a little bit higher to be more saturated or lower, depending on what you're going for. And then we can go to the last segment, and I'll quickly do the same, and I'll change it to a pink color. So once all the adjustments are made, I'm going to press enter or return key to preview how it looks, and you can see the color changes are working great. And there's one last step, just doing some color correction to the overall video. If you're not familiar with Lumetri scopes, I recommend watching my full tutorial linked up here in a card that kind of goes into depth on how to use scopes. So from the Lumetri scopes, you can see that the image is too dark. We want to bring up this Luma waveform to get as close to 100 as possible and bring it down a little bit to 0 to add more contrast. So let's go to the project panel and let's right click on this empty region to create a new adjustment layer. And then we can drag the adjustment layer onto the third layer in our timeline on top of all of the layers. Then go back to the scopes, make sure that those are open. And with the Lumetri color open as well, we can go to the RGB curves this time and make sure the white is selected, which is the Luma curve, which controls the brightness level. So what we can do is click on the top right and bring that over to the left to make the image brighter, and you'll see that the waveform moves up closer to 100. And then we can do the same with the bottom left. We can move it straight over to the right just to add a little bit more contrast. You don't want to add too much, just a slight amount. And after that is done, we can go to the creative section. And here you can add in a little bit of vibrancy if you like. And once it's done, you can click on the effects button to see the before and after, and you can see it just looks a lot warmer and brighter. So after you do all of those steps, here is the final effect that you can create for your own videos. So if this video tutorial helped you out, be sure to give it a big thumbs up. It helps me know if you guys want more TikTok content on this channel. If we can get to 1,000 likes, that would be awesome. And I know that we can do it because I've seen you guys get way above that as well. Also, be sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell because then you're notified when I publish new content. And if you want other TikTok effects, I've already created one on how to do the dance motion effect where the camera follows your subject. This was another Florist Creates effect, so you can click up here to watch that. And once again, a huge thanks to Mixkit for supporting today's video. Be sure to check it out. They have tons of free stock video, music, sound effects that you guys can start using in your own videos without any licensing issues. And if you want access to more, Mixkit was created by Envato Elements. So if you want more video clips that are similar and more templates, you can check out Envato Elements. I have a 70% off discount, which I've linked down to below. All right, as usual, that's all for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching, and keep creating better video with Gal. All right, see you next time.